this is H.J. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy XII! Today, I've decided to spawn the Midgard Sarmer, the rare game that I missed last time. It's a raw 20% spawn rate, so it's nothing too challenging there. I might want to wake up about fear there. But, one other thing about Midgard Sarmer that makes it a little difficult to spawn is that it can spawn in, like, four different locations. I've heard only in the northern half of this area before you get to, like, the level 40 enemy down below. So, I don't know entirely, but that's how I usually try to spawn it. You might remember this guy from Final Fantasy VII as the Midgard Zalem, but they, mistranslated it. A mistranslation in Final Fantasy VII? No. Yeah, so. I wonder if they're gonna clean up the translation at all in the PC version of the game. But anyway, this is where I spawned it. It could be in other locations, but this is usually where I do spawn it. Sometimes I might spawn it a little to the east, but no, usually I get it here. So, let's take a look at the rare games that I've gotten recently there. I don't know why they call it a bull crack. It doesn't look like a bull at all. Is there something in real life called a bull crack? I don't know. But anyway, yeah, they're all unrecorded. Well, gee, you think they're rare. It's only like one or two of them in the world. Someone was asking me, H.C. Bailey, once you kill a rare game, will it forever be lost? And the answer is no, you can respawn them again. There are special rare games that cannot respawn, but all the ones that I've done so far, you can respawn. So if you're trying to get like a rare steal from them and you already killed them, you can do that. And it the game will, it won't say, hey, you can't respawn it again, but there's a specific condition that will be met once you kill those certain ones that will say, that will indicate to you, no, there's no way you're going to be able to respawn these guys. So, yeah, just so you know how that all works. But I'm not interested in stealing from rare games. It takes too long. And most of them don't have interesting stuff to steal anyway. So, I'm also trying to get more LP, so that way I can get those licenses for everyone else that I missed before. So I'm a little behind on LP right now, but, I've almost gotten all the ones that I really care about, so I suppose it's not that big of a deal. Let's see, the only licenses that I really care about, I want to get the MP licenses, the remaining ones. And Serenity, not today, but eventually. And I think that should do. I mean, there's other licenses that I'd like to get, like Remedy Lore, Phoenix Lore, Ocean Lore, things like that. But I don't really care about those that much. So I'll get them whenever I get them. But sure, let's give this guy a potion. Why not? I'm in your debit. Oh, wow. Wonder what happened over there. Well, there we go. Oh, sure, why not? But before doing that, I need to save here and rest up. And I also want to change up my gambits a bit, too. So I'll take care of that, and I'll be right back. Okay, we're back, and I've gotten all the licenses for everyone. Everyone, 13,000 LP worth. However many it is, I don't know. I've also rearranged my gambits here, so just take a look. Most importantly, I've gotten the Smelling Salts gambit on everyone, so that way, because there's going to be some enemies coming up that can confuse us, so want to watch out for that. And I've also changed my Cura gambits to Curaga gambits now. Cura, not as big of a fan of. That hits all party members, and sometimes not everyone needs it, but Curaga, that's more, well, it's basically Cure, but stronger, it only single target. So now we've got to get to the Henne Mines, and oh, can I still borrow your chocobo? Thanks. For a second there, I was like, wait a minute, I only have one chance to get the chocobo? So remember what I was telling you about those chocobo prints? Well, there's a secret passage through there. I was gonna say, why is he telling us how to get to, like, their secret base or something? whatever, in the Magicite Mines or something. I don't think you can take the chocobo through the Gomor jungle. Can you? I forget. Not that I'm really worried about it. While you're on your chocobo, you cannot encounter monsters, and you will not be thrown off, unlike Final Fantasy XIII. So, yeah, I wouldn't worry about that. You could also, there's another path that you could take to get back to, what is it, Jahara, if you wanted to. Let's see if I can, I'm not going to actually go there, but maybe I can find the path for you. Huh. Thought it was around here somewhere. Ah, there it is. Yeah. So you take this path, it'll take you right back to Jahara. I'm not going to, but you could if you want. You could have just done that to bypass all of the enemies. But I wanted the LP. Well, what's going on?
Researchers from the Draclaw Laboratory. What were they doing here?
Research.
I just like how he says that. Like, research, you dumbass! They're researchers! What do you think? But anyway, alright, well, let's take a look at the mines. What's the worst that could possibly have happened here? I keep on saying that. Keeps on biting me in the ass. Yeah, let's, dismount! Come, Patsy! Wow, we've got like double the HP that Larsa has. Ah, thanks to all those HP licenses, they are so good. I like the swiftness licenses better, but the HP ones are helpful too. Got nice and mysterious music going on here. And another mine! But I do like how they change it up compared to the other mine, the Lusu mines that we went to, so it's not like the exact same area that we were just at. Maybe these guys have... Okay, they have another item that you can steal that actually is worth stealing. Or maybe it's the other one. No, it's the other ones. Okay, never mind. We need to get a lot of LP. I want to get those other MP licenses. The Inquisitor and Martyr licenses next. Okay, these guys don't have anything really worth stealing. Is there a... What is over here? Oh, the switch. Like, where's the treasure chest? Looking for one. Sure. Why not? What does that do? Uh-oh. Is it a trap? Oh. No, it isn't. Ah. If you kind of notice that back door there closed, these are sort of toggle switches where it'll close one door, but open another for you, and it'll change the paths that you can have access to. Oh, where are we going? Ah, there we go! You got Red Maw B, who you can steal that Crooked Fang from. I just like saying that. Crooked Fang. Oh. Yeah, what's this? Oh! Yeah, I suppose so. Yeah, just directions on what I was just telling you about, anyway. Now, we could just head to the left there, but I want to pick up the map here, so let's go do that. Aren't they your mines? I mean, I would think you would know. Hmm. Well, there we go. Uh-oh! What the? It's a trap! Okay, hold on. Now, these guys are weak to fire, but I don't have access to that. Or, multi-targeting fire spell. So, let's go with arrow this time. Yeah, you notice how all these spells cost a lot less this time around. Try to target the one in the middle if you can. Or, actually, let me see. Do they have anything interesting to steal? Oh, no, not really. One more arrow Oh, okay, maybe a couple more arrow spells would do. Okay, yeah, these guys are ambushing me. Okay, took care of all those guys. Yeah, whenever you flip one of those switches in these tight quarters, you'll probably get ambushed by a whole bunch of them, and you might die. If you choose to fight them, but I think we can handle them. If you got almost all the HP licenses like I do, then it's not really a big deal. You do want to make sure you're at full HP before doing that, though. Remember this place for later, because there's going to be another hunt that we can take care of here. Not right now, but in the future. Wow, that's a lot of bats. They messed up my hair! Alright, there we go. Let's take a look at how big this place could possibly be. Whoa! Yeah, this place is pretty big, so it's going to take us a little while to get through it. I might have to split this up into two episodes, but, well, we'll see. It is going to take a little while for us to get to the save point. Then again, if I get ambushed enough, I might just be editing out, like, half of my trip through here. So, I don't know. We'll see. Make sure you steal from those red moths. The Seekers, not so worried about. Yeah, you know what? Let's just go all out against them. Vanilla can steal from them? Great. Not much loss. Yeah, sometimes when you get one of those little medals from killing enemies, sometimes you'll get a little HP restored. Sometimes it'll give you, like, protect or shell. Okay, we're done there. So let's switch it back, and now we'll head to the left. Yeah, that path just loops around on itself. Yeah, no more enemies. It only spawns the enemies once, and there's a limited supply of them. If only there were a way we could just make it so that they would spawn infinitely there. That would make a great leveling spot. But sadly, we have no such way of doing that right now. Let's go after H. We already stole from him. I'm just gonna tear your fang off your hand before I kill you. Thanks. Yeah, you notice we're getting a lot of pebbles from these guys. Alright, there we go. Whoa. Where did you get money from? What, did you eat it from the soldiers that you killed? That would be an interesting way, or a bad way to go. Of course, I suppose any way to go would be pretty bad. But, eaten to death by bats? Holy cow. This part can get a little mazy if you didn't find the map, but I think we can handle it. Cricket Fang! Not quite as awesome as the Wicked Fang, but you take what you can get. There's some secret passages around here, too, through the mine that I'll try to show off if I can. Some of them I will, some of them not so much. I do want to get through this area today. Ah, there we go. No, this one's not so secret. Eh. See what else we... Oh, no, I don't want to... Well, yeah, I do want to look at the map, but... How are we doing on license points? Not bad. I do want to get up to 140 so that I can get certain licenses by the end of this area. That's all Kiraga restores? Wow. That's not good. Let's see. We want to go south, I think. Yeah, we want to go south. I'm not going to waste my time with the dead ends here today. Please don't teleport. Thank you. Ooh, the Grimoire Togale, something like that. Yeah, those sell for pretty good money. I would like to... Oh, yeah. Nuts. Yeah, Dark Magicite's probably their common steal. Oh, well. Can you steal from them, Bon? Thanks. I love that heavy spear. I'm going to hold on to that for quite a while. It's pretty useful. I missed my turn. Oops. Go back up! Back up! Die, you winged spawn of Satan. Yeah. Yeah, I like quoting Ace Ventura as much as the next guy, but... Why do they have these horses around here anyway? They used to belong to the Empire or something? It must be like mist around here or something. Maybe it's transforming the monsters. Yeah, we were just minding our own business here when the monsters came in. Don't you guys, like, have a paling or something? That's what they were saying in Bujerba. Just put these palings everywhere. At least they have a slightly better excuse for why monsters don't attack the towns or the mines or something. Not a very good excuse, mind you, but well, you take what you can get. It's like they have all these towns and they don't stand a chance against all these monsters. Well, then why don't they just raid your town? It's just a thought. Oh. Sure, let's take out this guy first. Why not? I think there is... No, I'm thinking of another place that looks just like this in the mine. Never mind. I was gonna say, I think there's a path to the south, but no, that's not until later. I may want to use a Cura at some point in time. Okay, there we go. Almost have all the LP that I want. I want to get up to 140 and get certain licenses for everyone. Now, let's see, that door is open and this door is open. Let's see, but if I'm not mistaken... Yeah, the far door behind this dinosaur guy is closed. So we gotta find a way to open it. Let me see here. Yeah, and that door is closed too. But we can get around that problem. Okay, so we don't want to go this way. Walk this way. We want to go this way. Yeah, some people were pointing out, Ichi Bailey, you know, if you got that Gladius back at the, what is that place? Jahara, that would have been really useful here, because, like, this guy's weak to wind, and the Gladius is a wind elemental weapon. And, yeah, that would have been useful, but all the weapons in that direction on the license board aren't really that great, so I don't want to, like, go out of my way just to get, like, one weapon that might be useful for a relatively brief period of time. Sink your teeth into me, why don't you? For some reason, I'm trying to think of a cereal commercial. Sink your teeth into something. The one with the vampire. Whatever cereal that was. Choco. This is the Dracula guy. Oh god, now that's really gonna bother me. Oh man. Don't you hate it when you're trying to remember something and it's like on the tip of your tongue but you can't remember it? Oh, whatever. It's like Choco Puffs or something. Cuckoo Puffs? No, that's the bird. Okay, well anyway. Now I should have the license points for everyone. Yes, okay, there we go. So, new licenses for everyone. Let's see, we want to get Phoenix Lore. I really hope this is the right one. Yes, okay, Martyr. You gain MP every time you take damage. It lets you regenerate your MP. Phoenix Lore, every time you get one of those, your Phoenix Downs restore a little more HP. And Inquisitor, every time you deal physical damage, you regenerate some MP. Unlike the War Mage Gambit, which works for magical damage. This only works for physical damage. They don't stack. At least I don't think they do. So I want to get these licenses for everyone, and I'll be right back. Okay, took care of all that. So now our MP problems are a thing of the past. Don't even need any of those... What are they? Those quickening licenses to double your MP. No, we don't need those. We're fine just the way we are. But yeah, if you get... Now let's see if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, we gotta find a way to open this door to get to the end. So, let's see. We need to go up here, I think. So yeah, if you get the Martyr license, the Inquisitor license, Headsman, and what's the other one? The War Mage license, along with the three channeling licenses, you will never have a problem with MP. Yeah, why don't you heal yourself up there? Try to spread out... Try to spread out the MP usage as much as we can. Now, I'd like to get up to 125 LP by the time I get to the end of the area. If I can, great. Not, well, that would annoy me. Okay, switch out my party members because the other ones were getting ahead on their levels there. So, trying to keep everyone about as even as possible there. That's how I like to play the game. If you just want to stick three party members, you can, but I like having reserves available for certain situations. Okay, we are all at full. This was a good time to switch party members because now we're going to get a big ambush here. So I'm going to take care of that and be right back if I can open the switch here. This is the switch, by the way. Whoa, holy crap! I thought you could only have six enemies at a time. Okay, took care of all those guys. Yeah, I had to run out because there were just so many of them. I could not handle that many at once. So. If only I had Fira for this area, but sadly we don't get that until, like, right after this area. Would have been nice to give it to us before we came into the area where we get ambushed by enemies that are weak to fire! But apparently not today. Yeah, you see, we're almost at, except for Boss, we're almost at near full MP for everyone. Even after wasting all my MP in that room. There we go. Yeah, I figure I might as well have Fran help out with that. Alright, we should be a straight shot to the end, or not. I'm forgetting about these guys. It's come out of the sky. Or, well, the ceiling. But you know what I mean. Okay, I know the character's name from that serial that I was talking about. I know it's Count Chocula. I just don't remember the serial that he was from. What is it, just Choco Puffs? No, that can't be it. It sounds too similar to Cocoa Puffs. No, not to that. Now I'm gonna have to look that up. See, I can't do that while I'm recording. That's why you see me, H.G. Bailey, why is your vocabulary so bad? Well, what do you want me to do? Look it up while I'm recording? So, yeah, kind of hard. I mean, I have three computers set up for all this, but... You know, I'm using one for a map, I'm using one for my notes, and... Well, the other one I'm using to record the actual video, so... I don't want to have... Oh, they just killed themselves, okay. Ah, whatever. Is this the final... save point area, or...? Oh, there we go.
Look at the Magicite. These mines much resemble the ones at Lusu.
It's almost like they're both mines.
Draklor must be searching for new sources of ore. Should the Resistance forces move, the rich veins of Magicite and Bujeba will be forever beyond their grasp.
Oh look, another dead soldier, like the other hundreds that we just passed up. Huh? Oh, another little bunny girl. Your hair's not so long, though.
The stench of humes. The stench of power. What's wrong with her?
Stay away! Power-needy hume!
Well, what's with her? That's a weird way to walk, but... Whatever works for her. What's wrong with Mjrn? Find out next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy XII! This is H.C. Bailey, signing off. Have a good day. Done.